last week. What an awesome week we had last week, right, church? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The revelation in knowing that Jesus loves us. God loves us. It's not how much we love God, but how much you and I understand He loves us. Sometimes we think we're not worthy. Sometimes we think that, we look down on ourselves. But God is telling us, that doesn't matter. If you come here and you open up your hearts, it's knowing how much God loves us no matter where we've been, no matter what we've done. And so that's awesome, isn't it, to know, church? Why don't you stand to your feet this morning? We serve such a faithful God. And many a times we could be going through things and we don't see that, but you know, hold on, hold on, hold on to God this morning and know that His faithfulness is for you and I. We may not get it when we want it, but trust the process that God has for you. And hold on to that He is a faithful God. In all that He does, He is faithful. Our God is faithful.
You are so faithful to me. us, O Faithful. Thank you for your faithfulness, O God.
Yes.
We give you glory and give you praise, O God. Thank you for your presence in this place. Where the presence of the Lord is, there is liberty, there is freedom. And I speak healing, I speak deliverance, Father, this
day.
I speak life.
Yes.
I speak of God, the grace of God, oh God, the grace of provision, the grace of healing, the grace of strength, oh God, to this place. Thank you for your people. Thank you for the way that you manifest yourself to and real. God, upon their lives, you are so true, you are so real. God, Jesus, we love you. Jesus, we worship you. Thank you for your faithfulness upon each one of us. Thank you, Lord, for this time that we can come together, God, and offer our sacrifice of praise and worship. Because you are worthy to be worshipped, praised, and honored. Thank you for all that you accomplish in us, through us, and among us this morning. God, we give you all the glory and the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, dear Father, we pray all the same prayer. Thank you, praise and worship. Be blessed. Hallelujah. The Lord always inhabits the places of His people. He always show up when His people like you and me worship Him. He's showing up here this morning.
He
inhabits the places of His people. And we thank God for His presence. It's a privilege to be here this morning. It's an honor. Thank you so much, Pastor Tuatepi, for allowing me to use your pulpit this morning. Thank you, Pastor Sitareki. Hallelujah. I'm so blessed ever since we know each other. God's a God of connections.
Amen.
He connects us for a purpose.
Yes.
That's why I'm here this morning. So we thank God for the privilege. The title of my message this morning is Fight the Good Fight of Faith. Faith is a fight.
Yes.
We access everything from God through faith. We access the grace of God through faith. We are saved by grace through faith. We activate the power and the blessing of God through faith. And I will start with giving my testimony this morning. I was diagnosed with cancer in the year 2017, January. The doctor said that I had the most aggressive cancer. Almost 12% of the cancer cells in my blood. It goes through all my body. They don't know how to treat it. They said it's stage 4 cancer. With stage
4
cancer, they have no longer time to live. They asked me that I need a counselor to counsel me. It's not very long to live. My mind was in chaos. I was blue, you know, my mind was nearly blew up. But I thank God for His Spirit. My mind says a different thing altogether from my spirit. Within my spirit, I believe that God is my healer.
Holy Ghost is my counselor.
Jesus,
let me sing
this morning.
It's still the same yesterday, today, and
forever.
He is my healer.
And I told them I don't need a counselor. Because I believe God will heal me.
Thank you, Lord.
So I started my journey. To find the good fight of faith.
Yes.
And because to access the healing power of God upon my life. I need faith. To access the grace of healing in my life. It's through faith. It reminds me in the Bible of the woman with 12 years of issue of blood. She pursued faith. She pursued and touched Jesus. Jesus didn't touch her. Jesus didn't touch her. But she touched Jesus. Jesus knew that, you know, something has gone out from him. The
nature.
He looked back and he saw that woman. He said, daughter, your faith has made you whole.
Amen.
You know, it's faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. The evidence of things unseen.
Yeah.
Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Those who come to him, those who come to God, should believe that he is. And he is the rewarder of those who diligently seek him. You're coming in this morning. You're coming in because you believe in God. Because you pursue your faith in God. Your faith in God is will access the grace of God.
Yes.
Will access the healing power of God.
Yes.
Will access the grace of God.
Yes.
That will minister to you. That will minister to you.
Yes. How will you get to God?
In whatever circumstances, yes, each one of us is encountering at the moment.
Yes.
He's your healer. He's your deliverer. He is the God of victory.
Yeah.
To cut my testimony short.
If I don't know, I'm from
and I started, you know, when they told me that I started to fight the good fight of faith. I started to get into the word of God. I started to rely on the Holy Ghost. To help me through. He is my helper.
To
believe in the word of God and memorize the word of God. Started the fight of faith. And I know that in the living testimony, today, the fight of faith. And I'm the living testimony today. And I got through my faith. You cannot depend on the pastor's faith. You got to stand on your own faith. Faith cometh by hearing by the word of God. Paul was saying, writing to Timothy, he said you have to flee from these things in 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 11. Flee from the love of money. Because the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. Money is good. But the love of money is not good. He said it's straight people, turns people away from faith. Because of greediness. Because of greediness. Because
they are greedy.
Praise
the
Lord.
Amen.
But he said, you flee from all those things. But pursue
faith.
Pursue righteousness.
Pursue
love. Pursue godliness. We've got to pursue faith.
And I
just want to share my experience through the fight. You will fight faith on the battle of your faith in your hearing and in your thinking. There are so many voices you can hear each day. The voices, to me, the voices of the doctor. The doctor's report. Medical science report. Even the name of the sickness, cancer, has a voice. It speaks death to me. Satan also has his voice. He went to the garden to Adam and Eve. He whispers in the ears of Eva. They caused them the fall. Satan still whispers in the ears of people today. The voices of discouragement. The voices that, oh, it's okay, don't go to church, you just stay home. The voice of defeat. The voice of fear. The voice of doubt. Satan fights you in your hearing. Always makes you busy. Not to hear the word of God. Not to come to church to hear the word of God. But faith comes by hearing, by the word of God. Yeah. Yeah. You need to come to church to hear the word of God.
Need the word of God.
Because it is important, the Bible says in 2 Peter 1:3. Because of his divine power. He has given us all things.
Not
some of the things. All things that pertain to life and godliness. That pertain to life and godliness. In our everyday life, we need it. Life and godliness, you know, worship the Lord as well. It's all, he said, all, according to his divine power, he's given us all things. That
pertain
to life and godliness. According to the knowledge of him that he will call us unto glory and virtue. Unto glory. That's why he's given us in verse 4, that's why he's given us great, exceedingly great and precious promises. The Word of God. That through these promises, you can be partakers of the divine nature.
Oh,
through the promises of God. Through the Word of God. Through Jesus is the Word. You can be partakers of his divine nature. The Word of God says His Word is spirit and their life. The Word will give you visions and energize you for success and program you for greatness. You have greatness in each one of us. Because Jesus is in us. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Word of God is so powerful. Full of life. And creative power. Sharper than a two-edged sword. That will pierce through the division of our soul and our spirit. Our marrow and our bones. And
these
are discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
Yeah.
So it's important to fill ourselves with the Word when you face with challenges. Every challenge, every issue in life, Jesus is the answer. It's only the Word. You've got to find the solution of the Word to your problem. You listen to it again and again, meditating upon it. It will work in your spirit. It will renew your mind. Renew your thinking. It's full of life. It's life in your spirit. And
love
in your whole body. Solomon, the wisest man ever lived. Solomon.
Oh, the Solomon got another photo.
He said, "My son, pay attention to my word. Incline your ears to my saying. Do not let it keep away from your." Do not let your eyes away from it. Keep it in the midst of your heart. For they are life to those who find it. And health. And medicine. And healing. To all your flesh. There you go. Hallelujah. He's our healer of the flesh. Healer of the spirit. Healer of the soul. He is our healer. Whatever you hear, it gets into your mind. Your mind consists of your emotion, how you feel. Your reasoning. Your will, where you make your choices. So it is important. The Bible says, for though we walk in the flesh, Paul says, but we do not war against the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but carnal. But mighty. Through God. In the pulling down. Of stronghold.
You
said casting down. All imaginations. All arguments. Every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
It'll
get into your mind. Your situation will, you know, things that you hear will get into your mind. This year you've got to cast down all arguments. All that comes into your mind. That is against the knowledge of God.
That
is
saying
you bring into captivity. Every thought to the obedience of Christ. Trade is important. I fought that battle. It was a fight to cast down whatever the negativity that comes to my mind. I've got to bring it down to the obedience of Christ. The thought of cancer means death. The doctor's report. In your cases, whatever the situation that you come through. You've got to cast it down. You've got to put into captivity. To the obedience of Christ. You are what you are because of what he says you are. The doctor says that I've got cancer. But what he says about I am a healed person because of Christ.
Amen.
You are what you are through Christ.
Amen.
So I've got to cast down all those arguments and those thoughts. Because it was proved medically. It was proved medically.
Everything
that you meditate upon, you can
have
it in your body. That is medical science. If you think negativity, if you accept whatever the doctor, said about me, about my health,
and
be happening to me according to my faith. No, I refuse that. I've got to bring it to captivity. To the obedience of Christ. I receive what Christ has done for me. He's already done it as a cross.
Yeah.
He has done a completely complete work. A perfect work at Calvary. He paid for my pain and my sin. It was on him. That's who I am in Christ. But it is a battle. But it is a battle. It is a fight.
Yeah.
To believe that,
we
try to faith.
Right.
Whatever they do here. It will influence your mind. It will affect our emotions. Affect the decisions and the choices you make. It affects the step that you take. It will determine your destiny. My destiny is in Christ. My destiny is in Christ. Your destiny is in Christ. That's why he's done all that at Calvary. So that you may receive the grace of the solution of whatever that you are going through right now. Praise the Lord. And then what are you seeing? That is, what are you hearing and what are you thinking? But this one and the second one is, what are you seeing? What do you see? The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12,
he
said, put aside every weight and every sin that is easily beset us. Looking up to Jesus, the other, and the finisher of your faith.
Amen.
What are you seeing? It is important.
Que te si o fue mamá o tu mamá que si su. Hoy a camatana me encantaba de tau tui.
2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18.
O Corinto a tol me te ves en dajal.
The Bible says as you behold him in the mirror, the glory of God. As you behold him.
Yo va kai que te ya.
That's in the mirror, the glory of God. You be transformed to the same image from glory to glory. If you behold negativity, if I behold the doctor's report, I'll be transformed to the same image of what I've been said about me and my sickness. No, I behold Jesus. I'm the old Jehovah Rapha. After 3 months, they called me again and they took my blood. And they said, something is happening. And I was smiling and I said, yes, I expect it. They asked me, how do you know?
Que fue
a
la hora.
have a problem with the 10 spies. They focus on the giant. And on the promise of God. What are you seeing today? You seeing your problem? You seeing your giants? Are you seeing God? God. Are you seeing God? Are you seeing the giant? When David faced this giant Goliath, he didn't see Goliath. He saw the other giant
is
bigger than Goliath. He saw the other giant is bigger than Goliath. He said to Goliath, you're coming to me with sword and spear and
javelin.
But I come to you
in the name of the
Lord of hosts, God of the armies of Israel. Hallelujah!
Amen.
What are you seeing? Seeing your giants?
Seeing
the God who is bigger than Abraham? It is important. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. How do you see your God? We
sang
about the Jesus this morning. We sang about Jesus. He who comes to God must believe that he is.
He
is our unchanged God. Omnipotent God. All-powerful. Omniscient God. Omniscient God, who's all-knowing.
He knows you.
He calls you by name.
Of the Father.
Far above all principalities.
Oh, maluma ya ya to.
Powers. Dominion.
Eki.
Those whom we are fighting against. And the Bible says, he has lifted us up. Ephesians 2:6.
If so, who are
they? Hallelujah. Far above all principality. And powers. And rulers of darkness. Speaking wickedness in high places. Far above all names. It is named. The name of cancer. The name of situation, whatever it is. You are seated far above. You are above, not under. You are the head, not the tail. You have dominion over all circumstances. That's how you see yourself. You should see yourself of how God sees you. And I show myself that way. But it's a battle. It's a battle. It's a fight.
Go down.
The fight of faith.
Go down forward. Go down.
Hallelujah. I know my time is up.
Go in and go awesome timing.
But next thing quickly, what are you saying? What are you thinking? What are you hearing? What are you saying? What are you saying? Life and death is in the power of the tongue. When you encounter this situation, what are you saying? When I go through that fight, I heard the voice of death. Then I said, no way. Psalm 118:17. I shall not die, but live and declare what the Lord has done. I'm declaring, I'm
taking
what the Lord has done for
me.
When I heard the voice of sickness, of cancer, this speaks death to me. I said, this sickness is not unto death. But for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through my testimony.
Hey,
you better be the Word of God. Better be the Word of God. 1 Timothy 1:18. Paul was speaking to Timothy, a young pastor. He said, use the word that you've heard, that you've spoken to you. Use it in your battle, in your fight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I thank God for the privilege. That's why the meditation, the process of meditation is
for you.
To meditate upon the word of God.
The
word of God is your weapon.
Power
in the words that you speak. Life and death
We more we where my death.
It's in the power.
Okay,
not the tongue.
In
Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Start to declare and declare. Start to decree and declare.
Oh,
prophesy to your life.
Your family.
I speak every day until today. I'm speaking to my situation. To my circumstance. The Bible says, Job 22, verse 28. Whatever you decree and declare, it shall be established. What are you saying? What are you saying to the children if they do something wrong? What are you saying to your spouse?
Okay, Faina, get down, hang out.
pomponini e il folo folo che stanno facendo qui. O tu dite che l'ama per fuoco tu vuoi tu una testimoni o pomponi come lì. Testimoni a fare tutto come lì, che è sana e fuori e muovi. O tu dite che una farà ossia e muovi che è della. Ma stanno facendo male. Fala malo ko hi fa ngai fa ina tu ina ma ho ta mai ve ki ko ni ke de tau a ke tau le le yo tu i me ve nai ko he pon ko ki ni me ali o ku ke tau e tau le le yo tu i ke ku ke fa no go ke ke li poti o ko mai ko ke te ko o ke te la ma me a he ka ki te la ma fa ha nga we ke te ko fa no go he pon ko ki ni ke la o ai ta mai ve ki fa fe tau na ne tu guane ai nga hita la noa ko ni mo na idea ko ni kai tu ia ke me ko le a ki e o tu a ie ne folo fola ko ia ho ta o fola mo ui ko ne o si ai di o no si no tu tu ki ke ko lo si ka le ba ka ko e mahalo ke be mai ka ko ha ko to e fo wa he maha ki ko ha ko to e fo wa he fa nga ta ia mo na me ko fo wa he la ya o ku ta mo ui he ma mani he nga i a ko ni ka fie ma o ke tau a ema he tui ko sias ki tau tole ki a honi. Ko hea mea teke tui ki ai. Mea pamo he ngai, he ngai a honi ku lahi ake tau whanongo ke mea koe. O ku hau me tapa aki koe, me tapa aki koe, me tapa aki koe. Kai tupo he folo fola ai o tua ai o ma hui ka lahi ke te koe pia koa. Ko he folo fola ai o tua koe lea mai ai o tua ke te koe pia koa pe koe. O ku ke tui ki ai pepai. Ko ngai koe ni mahui ngai pito ku lame ke ai e ta mai o eki. Hai me a go ke fa no ki ai. Ko hai me a ko ke si o ki ai. Ko hai me a ko te lea aki hou mutu. Lea ake mo ui, lea ake tu ui. Lea aki ke me a go ke fo wai. Wafa si su karasi. Te ke ikuna koa. Te ke fo wa tu pe go te ke ikuna. Pong pong ini. Iho tu anga he pong pong ini. E lea tu pe lea. O e whakata e tae tui mo e vei vei mwa ke te koe ki ho whakatoa kau me poko ni. O te ke tui koe ki ai. O kui kei ke mo oni ia. Ko hi ko mea iana e mate, ko hai iana e pehe, ko hai iana e pehe. Ko e pong pungi ni, whakamanate mai he tangata malanga ke te ki tau tolu. Ko sisu kalai si, o ta tau ia ane a fia ahone. Pea tae nata. Ko e whola whola he kai pe tau li liu ia. Ko e whola whola ia e o tua, ko whakatu mao ia. E hau e tau tamata, e alwe tau tamata, kai he tuku mau pe a wholawholai a e o tua. Pea ko ki nā tolo pe o tutui ki ai, te nā langa whakamoane, te nā langa sio ki ai, he ngai hau koe. Whawheta i ki he e ki. Wangu pangini, te whakata pe e whenga maari ake te tau tole pongpongini. Hima mai peka hima e pongpongini. Ki ha taha pe he pongpongi koe ki, ko tui o lea pe wholawhola, ke te tau tole kotoa he pongpongini. Ko e ha ho tari ke wholawhola a e o tua, he pongpongini. I he mea ako ke whowai, we find a tap. We make a good four way. See you. Give it all to us. I am a good luck young lady. He made a good four way. Pongo in you down for a man over the five time. For a man over the way, what do I pongo in there? Oh, hop, hop, for a man with five years, my little lag. I am a good one. When I find my dad, who let
Wafai kuna mulama mea sisu klaisi kwa mawegi kwa mawegi kwa mawegi.